One more time.
Is that because of the trap?
Okay. No, I didn't see the...
Don't hurt your back. We don't have workers' comp.
Give me a hand?
No.
Why?
I'm documenting this.
Yeah, I told you, you can just come over to my room.
Under my special skills on my resume.
I'm sure it is.
Did you...
It's probably the only thing that's there.
Oh, nice.
I bet you I can get tears in the first interview.
Who? Mom or Dad?
Don't assault me.
All right, what's the bet then?
Sizzler.
That salad bar run you up.
And the dessert tray.
Can I ask you guys a question?
What?
Oh, God.
What's the story with the girl?
She's a garbage pill user. Oxys, benzos. Dad was a drunk. Probably beat her up.
I'm thinking molested.
Seriously?
We'll find out.
What are oxys and benzos?
Wow. Is that what you said? Are you kidding me? Where did you find this guy? Why hire professionals? And you get Craigslist over here.
You guys know I'm hearing this, right?
Oh, I'm so sorry. Where did the company get your resume again?
Craigslist.
Yeah. How much longer, film school?
I'm almost done.
You're almost done?
Yeah.
Mic one?
Okay.
Mic two. Mic one? Mic two. Are we good?
Yeah. Yeah, we're ready. Let's go.
I look into the camera, or do I look
at... Is it too late to want to go to the bathroom?
Yes. Okay. So let's start from the beginning. What are your earliest memories about Carson?
When she was born, she was so perfect.
She was a blessing. An absolute blessing. She liked to tag along, you know, with me, and she would... You know, pretend to do the same things that I was doing, and...
She's good and nice and kind and, she's really smart and talented.
She loved Sunday school. She practically memorized the whole Bible. You could name any verse. She could quote it right back to you. We are religious. We go to church every Sunday.
Carson, too?
She used to.
She got a scholarship to, East Lake. It's a real prestigious Catholic school. We're not even Catholic. That's how smart she is.
Does my hair look okay?
Yeah, you look great.
Okay. Carson came to East Lake junior year, and she didn't really know anybody, you know. She's new. But I kind of always try to be nice to the new kids. You know, I mean, yeah, it's a Catholic school, but it doesn't mean everyone has religion. But she did, and she was... always wanting to do the right thing, and she just wanted to fit in. I missed hanging out with her. I miss her. I can't hang out with a junkie.
Just one second. Sorry about that.
Just doing your job.
There we go. Okay. Can you do me a favor? Tell me what you...
Okay. Here we go. What is your full name?
Carson Morris.
And what is your drug of choice?
Heroin.
Put that in a complete sentence for me. Your mother told me you can quote practically the whole Bible from memory.
Not the whole Bible. I know a lot of verses. I used to.
Jason, hand me that Bible behind you, please. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 18.
I know that one. For because he has suffered when being tempted, he is able to help those being tempted. I nailed that.
Yes, you did. That was very cool. Very cool, Carson.
Why are you filming me?
I just want you to see yourself.
Stop filming me.
She started to argue a lot. We just thought it was just some kind of teenage rebellion kind of thing, but...
East Lake is very expensive. And these weren't the kind of kids that Carson was used to being around.
I don't know, I guess she just wanted to fit in, and she didn't.
She'd start going out at night, and she wouldn't come home, call or anything.
And then she started dressing in that goth way, which really disturbs me.
I swear it was like she changed overnight.
She just became...
like a zombie. She became like a zombie.
It, like catatonic.
Yeah, she would just lay in bed and she wouldn't wake up. When we try to wake her up, she'd just sleep and sleep.
And the drinking and the drugs came after that. Sometimes her eyes... it's like nobody's home. And she doesn't always remember what she did. I'll ask her.
Sorry, it's just a bump.
We just finished services, and the entire congregation was coming out of the church. Fortunately, she ran out of energy, and we were able to help her and calm her down.
Beth, she blames the school, mostly. And I tell her it's not the school, it's not the other people, it's us.
Steve took it pretty hard when his business failed. We were struggling financially. I think he just felt like he wasn't providing enough for us.
So that was the only thing that caused tension at home?
No, I have anger issues. I'd say that, yes. But I control them.
How do you control them?
I just sort of be quiet and...
Can you put that in a complete sentence? I control my anger issues by...
I control my anger issues by just holding them inside and being quiet.
Is that really dealing with them, though?
I don't know. What do you want me to do? Throw the TV through the window or something? That's dealing with it.
No, that's not what I want.
I eventually told him that if he didn't get sober, that it was over, and I'll leave, and I'll take Carson with me. God was a very big part of that.
Carson, do you believe in God?
I don't know. If there is a God, I don't really think he cares about me much.
Carson, why can't you stop just for one day? See how it feels.
Because when I stop, I want to slit your fucking throat.
I find needles, I find pills. She lives to get high. It's all that she cares about. Drugs have darkened her. They squashed her spirit. I've tried really hard to be a good mother. I've tried to, I want her to be a better woman than me.
I'm not really sure what you're wanting to see.
No, this is great. We just need the cutaways. On the show, we'll cut to, you know, like one of those photographs.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, I'll just.
But then,
I'll
could you just?
Stay right over
but
here.
Actually, I need you to actually just step out of the room for a sec while
okay.
we.
Because
with
you're,
too
don't
many
touch
people,
anything
the lighting gets.
Because
yeah,
she's
no
really
problem.
Particular.
Listen, Beth. Thank you.
Okay.
Seriously.
Oh.
We will. We'll be right there. Thanks.
All right.
Check the drawers.
She just said not to touch anything.
Come on, dude. This is what we do. Her journal, her diary. Use your imagination. We don't have a lot of time. She's gonna come back.
Okay.
No, this is like her underwear.
No.
That's good. That's good stuff. Huh. You likey.
Oh. What do you think this is about?
What?
Look at these. Demonic possession and mental illness. What do you think this is all about? That could be something, huh?
Wait a minute.
You think so?
We've got a teenage addict trouble at home into Satan. Seriously, this girl's got real secrets. I need you to go find them, okay?
I'll do it. I got it.
Look under the bed.
All right.
Check out the creepy dollhouse. Hey, Carson.
Find anything good?
Dude, I'm gonna stop rolling 10.
So, how many episodes of this have you actually shot?
Is this 20 questions? I don't know. 8?
Sure.
9? 9. 9?
Cool. What's the ratio for the show?
What? Success ratio?
Yeah.
Half and half? You're 50% still sober after 6 seasons.
Oh, it's a coin toss, so... She's really pretty, don't you think?
Not for long, man. Junkies get old fast.
Well, maybe she'll get better.
Oh, you're one of those dudes that needs to, like, rescue women.
No, are you crazy? No, I don't.
Did they teach you that in film school, too? You just seen too many bad movies. You write poetry?
What are you
doing? I'm just getting an exterior.
Did I ruin your shot?
It's okay.
How about this?
Do you see the house like this?
Yeah, it's perfect now. Hey, do you mind if I ask you a question?
Sure.
I saw those books in your room about demonic possession.
Yeah?
Do you believe in that stuff? Like, actually?
Do you?
Oh, that's my camera.
Yeah, so camera guy.
Yeah.
You believe in demonic possession?
I don't know. I haven't seen any evidence of it.
What would you consider evidence?
I don't know.
Jason!
Oh, sorry. I gotta pop off that shot. Sorry.
Like, I have time for this right now?
I know. Sorry, she's...
Just a second. If the nuns at East Lake knew what I was doing with this tie. So, what channel is this going to be on?
It's for educational purposes. Schools, stuff like that.
My mom gave me these scented candles for Christmas. This one's called Holiday Home. I like it.
It's very festive.
Almost there. There we go. Can't even. It's good. It's like insulating me.
Carson.
Jason.
Your wrist is bleeding.
Get out of my shots.
Oh, thanks. Rule number one for a spying junkie is always keep a tissue close at hand.
You know, I haven't had time to read the background today.
Only 3 pages, my friend.
I've been sitting on a plane for 2 hours and a terminal for 4 hours, so the background really hasn't entered into my... Thank you. And I have to counsel these people on camera in 5 minutes. I could appreciate some goddamn support and then a little water.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Addict's name is Carson. She's an IV heroin user.
She has blackouts, personality changes, severe mood swings.
Who are the parents?
Dad is Steve. He's enabling. Guilty about his own past alcoholism. Mom is Beth. She's religious. Prays for Carson to get better. Jesus has not stepped in thus far.
History of abuse, trauma.
Nothing yet. Nothing, 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 nothing. I've been digging. Mom spanked her a couple of times. Dad drank for a few years. We can do parental neglect, but it's not very sexy. Maybe something else will come out in rehab.
All right, Mom, let's start with you. What are you prepared to do today if Carson refuses treatment?
Kick her out of the house.
Dad, are you prepared to back her up on that?
Can I be honest?
Your daughter's life's at stake. You better be.
I don't think that I want to throw her out of the house. I mean, if she's out on the street, what's she going to do to buy drugs? As long as she's here, she's...
As long as she is here, she has a free place to stay. She has money for pills. It is very easy for her to be an addict here. And I'm not saying it's your fault, Dad, but you are helping her stay addicted. Understand me? The only chance she has to get better is if you draw the line.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'll do it.
Dame Prentice, please have a seat.
No, I'm not doing this right now.
All you have to do is listen. Nobody here is going to force you to do anything.
I need to go to my room first.
I want you to listen to what they have to say before you use. Carson, we're not going anywhere until you hear us out. Please have a seat.
I've seen you go from a straight-A student who memorized Bible verses to a junkie who would do anything to buy her pills. If you don't get help now, I will no longer give you an allowance. And as painful as it is, I can no longer stand by and watch you kill yourself right before my eyes.
Good. I'll leave.
And go where?
Steve, that's enough. So you won't get help.
You can't help me.
Mom?
Carson. We love you so very much. And we are so very proud of all that you have accomplished. But we can't stand by any longer and watch you destroy yourself. The path that you now travel is troubled, and I just believe that this is the Lord's way of answering all our prayers.
The Lord does not care about me.
What? Maybe that's because you've been defying him.
I'm not defying him!
Shh, shh.
Okay, McKee?
Carson, you're a really good friend, and I really want you to get better. We used to have so much fun together, then all of a sudden things changed.
Carson, stop right now! What are you doing? Just leave her alone!
Carson, stop it!
Let her go. Everybody just let her go. Everything's okay. Carson, I'm coming in. Carson, what you're going through is not uncommon. I've been through it myself. I'm an addict, too. I lost everything. The drugs, I lost my job, my family, my self-respect.
Yeah, but now you're a big TV star, so I guess it all worked out pretty well for you.
It worked out for me because I got help. I know how you feel. You don't like using drugs. You're not getting high anymore. You are a maintenance user. You just don't know how to stop.
You don't know what this is.
Tell me.
You won't believe me.
Try me.
No, thanks.
Tell them how you really feel, Carson.
What are you talking about? What's he talking about?
I don't know. Jason, shut up.
Carson,
it's okay. Look at me.
There's something evil inside of me.
And you're using drugs to keep down that evil, violent feeling. All kinds of names for what you're going through. That's what addiction is. You're possessed. But you can get better, Carson. There's still good in you.
I'm so tired of fighting it.
Then let us help you.
I'm doing it.
Oh, it was great. Oh, she freaked out. She attacked her friend and tried to shove her letter down her friend's throat.
And she thinks she's possessed.
Yes, possessed. He followed right up on it, of course. Okay, cool. Yes, we absolutely will. Oh, no, you got your promo footage today. I'll tell you that right now. You're welcome. Bye. Yes.
You're going to do great. Dean, how are you? Good to see you.
Doris, great to see you.
All right, welcome. You must be Carson.
Yeah.
Dr. John Cordes, nice to meet you. Welcome to Hope Center.
Nice to meet you.
You're in the right place.
Stick your tongue out.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to check your eyes, okay? You want to look at this one? I'm just going to check your bag, okay? Mm-hmm. No drugs or alcohol, or you'll be expelled immediately. If you have anything, you let me know. Okay.
How's it going in here?
Good.
Good. Listen, I just want to give you an idea of what's going to be going on over the next week or so. When was your last use?
About 6 hours ago.
So in the next few hours, you're going to be experiencing withdrawal. You know what that's like already, though, don't you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's going to get worse. But you won't be alone. By the fifth day, the drugs are going to be out of your system. You're going to be clean. That's when the real work begins, okay?
Okay. If those keys are going to make noise, just set them down sideways, please.
I just need to find the right pocket. What?
You going to do that?
Oh. You want this stuff? Let's go.
Yeah, let's see it on.
Carson is at the beginning of the detox process, and physically it should be getting easier for her, but psychologically the challenges are only just beginning. What she's been doing with drugs is self-medicating. And as she begins to go through recovery and clean the drugs out of her system, she's going to lose this coping mechanism. Ironically, her mood and her behavior could get worse as she gets clean.
And has Carson talked to you about demonic possession?
I've had people come into this office and tell me that they were aliens. I had a woman sit right in that chair and tell me that she was Marilyn Monroe. So I prefer not to take their claims seriously and legitimize those delusions.
Talk to you for a minute about Carson.
That's that new little girl, huh?
Yep, that's the new little girl.
I haven't really talked to her much. She doesn't talk to anybody.
Can you say that like in a complete sentence, like Carson doesn't really talk to anybody?
Carson doesn't really talk to anybody.
So what if I told you she thought she was possessed? Can you talk about that?
You know, I actually think that's kind of fucked up. I don't...
What exactly do you think fucked up? Can you just put that in a complete sentence?
Carson needs help.
I see.
She doesn't need you.
Most of you guys know how we start out evening group, but we have somebody new here. So, you know, before we start, we always introduce ourselves by saying our name and why we're here. Eric, why don't you start us off tonight?
My name's Eric. I'm here because I got popped at the airport. So now I'm missing my band's tour, which is fucking great.
Why are you really here?
I'm a heroin addict.
I'm Felice. I'm an addict. Crack cocaine.
I'm Callie. I've been doing coke and alcohol since college.
Hey, I'm Adam. I'm dually addicted. Drugs, alcohol, sex. Combination of the three usually works the best.
I'm Judy, and I like scotch. And I have to say that I'm an alcoholic in order to be here.
Hi, I'm Julia. I'm an addict. I do coke, crack, LSD, MDMA, everything.
Carson, heroin, pills, Pon-80s, Klonopin, and Xanax for about a year now.
So you're the demon girl?
What?
Callie, that's enough.
What? They said she was possessed by a demon.
It's normal to feel like that. We all do.
It's not just a feeling.
Okay. I'm sorry. I know we're on TV and everything, but this is fucking stupid.
We're taking Carson's feelings seriously. Carson.
I don't know this stuff out there that we don't know. Who's to say she don't got a demon? Like, she do some crazy shit like she got a demon. So, maybe she got a demon. I mean, you telling me it can't happen? You know? Like, I don't know everything. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not gonna lie as if I do.
She doesn't want to talk to me, but she's talking to our PA, Jason. Jason. Yeah, we will. You got it.
No, it's recording. You see the indicator there?
Yeah.
Oh, if you don't like looking at yourself, you can just flip it back this way. But you need to at least start with the screen out so you can make sure you're framed, okay?
Okay.
So once it's on, you just start saying diary stuff, things you might not feel comfortable saying with other people here.
Oh, private, personal stuff that I only want to share with about 3 million viewers.
Yeah. I guess it might have some therapeutic value. You can say how you feel, you can let off steam. Whatever, it's kind of like your own personal friend. Anyhow, when you're done, you just push that button.
Going back to school.
Next year, if I can make enough money.
And then you what? Make movies?
More likely, I get the same job, but you know, in the grand scheme of things.
Yeah, I remember the grand scheme of things. I was gonna be a marine biologist.
You still can be.
We'll see.
Here, you try it. I think you got it. I think you're actually gonna be okay.
Yeah. Detox has been really hard. I'm sore. I'm sick. And I don't know why I'm here. I said I'd try this, but I know it's not gonna work. I'm doing this for Mom and Dad, so at least they'll be safe. But the bad feelings are coming back. They're coming back, and I don't know how to stop it.
It gets worse before it gets better.
You don't know.
Believe me, I know. I've faced this before. I've been doing this for 25 years.
I'm trying to warn you.
I appreciate that. But right now, just tell me about these feelings that you're having.
Judy das quasi nick nick sura. Nafara.
Carson? Let's stop for today, okay?
Hi.
Hi, Carson. Give me a hug. I don't like being touched right now.
It's just part of the withdrawal, right?
That's right.
Okay.
Hey, this is a real nice place. They got tennis courts.
It's gorgeous.
It's nice.
Yeah. You're looking good. You're getting more of your color back and yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Are you making some friends, you know, connecting with some other people? Are there some people around here your age? I'm sure there are.
Yeah.
Yeah? How about we pray for a minute? We pray together.
Okay.
Let's just put our hands together, okay? All right. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Stay here. Carson. Carson!
Steve! Oh my God.
Okay, for the record, today is October 12th. This is Carson's third day here. Step Inside Recovery is not helping her. She's not getting any better. I found these in Carson's trash. Everything's about death and violence.
Here's another one.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
What are you shooting?
Nothing. I'm not shooting anything.
Oh.
Oh, my God. Look at this. Get that. Like, something's going on with her. She just puked right in her mother's face.
Yeah, well, that's what happens in recovery, Jason.
Everybody pukes in recovery.
How many times have we seen this? What, tons of times? Hundreds.
Now take my stockings off your head. Let's go see what she's doing.
So we are all of us when we get out of here. You're going to deal with slippery people, slippery places. You're going to need some tools to be able to deal with that. So what we're going to do here is a little bit of a role play where Eric is going to be one of those people for Carson. Eric?
You want to get high with us?
No.
Why not?
I don't use drugs, and I'd appreciate it if you wouldn't offer me drugs again. And if you do, I won't be able to hang out with you.
Fair enough. Let me talk to the demon.
What?
Well, you said you were possessed. Let me talk to the demon a second. I bet he wants to get high. Hmm? Here, demon.
All right, demon. Eric, that is unproductive. Step out, please. Carson, you did really well at first. You got a little bit flustered, but that's okay. You made good eye contact. You said all the right things. I mean, this is what we've got to do.
Look, I was just trying to do the exercise.
It's okay. Look, Carson, the purpose of this kind of exercise is to trigger feelings.
What?
Tina misses you in hell.
What?
And she's waiting. She's waiting for
Carson,
you.
Carson, stop it.
You fixed her last shot.
Hey, how do you know about Tina? No, how does she know about her?
Listen, I don't know.
You let her die.
Hey, leave him alone.
Felice, you filthy cunt. You left your daughter with a drug dealer, and he fucked her ass.
What?
Whoa. Carson?
Huh?
Carson, stand back. Give me some room here.
Let me go.
Shanti, get me 50 milligrams of carbamazepine. Get back. Carson, can you hear me?
What did I say?
You insulted them. They said you got into patient records interviews.
I didn't get into patient records.
I know.
I can't control it anymore. If something bad happens, I'm sorry.
I'm concerned. Carson's become a far more disruptive presence than I expected.
a high-maintenance patient, brings the others into her drama. And having a camera crew around here is not helping.
I know, I understand. And if it's too much, then we'll pull back. I don't want to be disruptive.
Is it okay if I ask a question? Why not let a priest do an exorcism? No, I mean, if it doesn't work, then she won't have that excuse to argue with anymore.
Well, if we feed the delusion, then what have we really done for Carson? We've just taken the reason that she's here in the first place and swept it under the rug. We just kicked it down the road.
Yeah, but if it works, then, you know, maybe you really cured it. She has all the signs.
And just what are the signs, Doctor? Really?
I don't know anything.
Okay, well, drastic changes in personality and voice. Seizures or convulsions, loss of memory, inexplicable bites, bruises, or injuries. Unnatural or superhuman strength.
These are also the symptoms of mental illness.
Well, speaking in languages she doesn't know.
Your concern is admirable. Okay, but if you really care, you'll let us help and not make things worse.
She doesn't need a witch doctor. What she needs is detox. She has detoxed and she's getting worse. People usually get better.
Hi, excuse me.
Yeah.
Hey. Can I interview you regarding Carson?
Yes, absolutely.
Great. All right. Did you put that under Carson's bed?
Hey, come on. I saw you in the hidden cameras. And I saw you making the cross on yourself when she was sick.
Do you think this is more than just a drug addiction?
I've seen this before. Okay.
Here?
No. In my village in Cameroon, when I was a young girl, there was a lady in my church. She was just like this.
Do you remember what they did to help her?
Yes. They tied her to the oldest tree in the village.
They prayed over her.
And they covered her with the blood of the goat.
Okay,
I know it sounds crazy to you, but they beat her with sticks, but the demon would not leave.
And this worked.
It did, it worked. But the woman, she died.
Great.
Hi. I don't know what to say. Are you watching this, Jason? I wish we could have met before all of this. I used to play this game with my friend McKee at the mall. We'd see how much free stuff we could get. Not like shoplifting, just free samples from the food court and perfumes and stuff, and just wish we could do stuff like that, normal, ordinary stuff.
And over here we have our resident demonologist, Jason Hurwitz.
Fuck off, Tim.
Dude, did you steal this from her room?
Go away.
Today is October 15th. I got my hands on this holy water. I'm doing this to prove that something real is happening to Carson.
I pretty much let all my family down. My progression through the years from marijuana, alcohol, hallucinogenics, to the harder stuff. My life became unmanageable.
When I'm high, this opens my mind, man. I can write for hours. Since I've been in here, I can't even string together a verse.
Either makes it better or just numbs you. Like, that's what I used to use when I had sex, to numb me out. I don't want to feel shit. I don't want to look at you. Like, I don't even want to know you're there. Like, you're gone and then I know.
It's the pain. It's inside. It's eating you. And I hate being here. I don't like you. Like all of you. I don't know you. I don't give a fuck.
I only ask that you don't get too caught up with your feelings. The people here in the room, this is a time to work on yourself.
Yeah, but this is completely useless.
You might feel like that today. You might not feel that way tomorrow.
And then we'll come back.
Well, what are you running away from?
Just have fun and destroying yourself? And like kill yourself every day? Oh, how fun it is. Fuck you.
Whoa.
Back off. Give her some room. Everybody, back off. Jason, get away from her.
Take God, take her out of the darkness and into the light.
Shanti.
Take God, take her out of the darkness and into the light.
Shanti. Are you okay?
Hey, can you stop?
How are you feeling physically? Like shit. How are you feeling emotionally towards the doctor and the process? Like shit. Yeah? Hello?
I heard you're out of the infirmary, but I can come back later.
No, it's okay. I was just... I don't even know what to say to it anyway. What's up?
I wanted to say that, I believe you.
You're the only one.
I wish I could actually do something for you.
You could, but...
What?
I can't ask you to.
What?
Not fair to you.
Just tell me and I'll decide.
This... it's not working. I'm not getting better like this and... I need something.
Okay, what?
I don't know any other way to control it.
I can't do that.
Carson, what are you doing? Carson, stop.
You wanna fuck her?
What? Carson, knock it off.
Carson, that is fucking disgusting.
Yeah.
She have a knife or like a carrot peel?
She like bit my finger. We need to tell someone. We need to get her some kind of real help.
This girl's freaking out. We should be filming.
What? Tonight?
Yes.
It's almost midnight.
I don't care.
You know, wake everybody up.
I don't care, Tim. You heard what Dale said. Go with the possession art. Get the goods. Then we'll decide if she needs a priest or a straitjacket or what. Does anyone have a problem with that?
Carson? Carson? Carson?
Fuck.
Where the fuck is she?
I don't know.
Oh my God.
Come on.
That's her!
Where is she? Hey, you guys see that?
Mm-hmm.
Hey! Okay. Carson?
She's not
out here. I want to go back.
Oh, listen. This way. Come on, come on, come
on, come on. Huh. Oh. Suzanne, Suzanne, Suzanne.
No.
Hey.
Running away? Carson, can you describe what happened to you tonight?
They were trying to help me.
Who was trying to help you?
Will you back off?
Jason, who were those people running away? What were they doing to you?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Who were those people running away? Who were they trying to help?
To fire my head nurse. Hope you got that on your cameras. Look, I'm recommending Carson for transfer to a psychiatric hospital.
So you're giving up, in other words?
We're not equipped to deal with the case.
So get equipped. Bring in more staff. God knows you get paid enough.
Hey, I handle five addicts pro bono for every one of
these. Bullshit, just spare me. We're all whores here, all right?
This girl is my responsibility. She is seriously ill, and you people have been covering it up. You're putting
fucking condescending
to
me. We're the only reason she has a chance.
Well, I'm making the medical decisions here. Okay, now I've ordered a full psych eval tomorrow, and I fully expect that I'm going to be recommending Carson for transfer.
Right. And I will recommend to Dale that we use another facility in the future.
Get the fucking cameras. Where are you going?
I gotta run some errands. Can you cover for me, please?
Where are you going? You going to get more holy water?
Tim, they're gonna institutionalize her.
Yeah?
Do you realize what's gonna happen if they put her in a psychiatric institution, man? She's not crazy.
If she's not crazy, they'll let her out.
Bullshit. They'll lock her up and throw away the key.
Can you stop trying to save this girl, you dumbass?
Take a deep breath, please. So, good. One more. Okay, thank you. So how are you feeling today physically?
Feeling better. I mean, I feel the worst part of the withdrawal is over, so.
Good. Have you been feeling depressed, anything like that? You spoke previously about being possessed by a demon.
I guess it was like a metaphor for that bad part of me that I felt that I couldn't control.
Okay, well, let's take your book.
I was checked earlier.
It's okay.
It was fine.
We need to take it again. It's part of the exam. What's this? I hate this. This is the worst part of my job. I'm gonna have to expel you.
It was the only way.
It is never the only way. You knew the rules when you came into Hope Center. Let's go pack your bags and call your parents.
Wait, she didn't do it. I did it.
What?
It was when she was unconscious. Okay?
You brought drugs into my facility?
Look, John. Wait,
you shit! Ow! Okay, I'm firing him. Firing him. Over. It's over. I realize what he did.
Suzanne,
it was totally out of line.
This is not just my job. This is not my career. This is not my
hospital. I know. I get it. I get it. But, John, let's not throw something up.
You hired him.
Shut the fuck up, Tim.
Get the goddamn camera out of our face.
What is your reaction to what's happened here today?
Reaction? You want a fucking reaction? I'll give you a fucking reaction. This is my reaction. You people are looking at a major lawsuit here.
Monday. From what I can tell, she still hasn't left the house.
You know, I keep thinking about the way that Carson attacked her friend at the intervention. There's definitely something weird about that.
Wednesday night, nothing.
Beth, it's Jason from the show. I need to check in on Carson.
What do you want?
Where's Carson?
I can't talk to you.
Look, what you're doing is not safe. You've got her locked up out there. She hasn't left the house in a week.
You don't know that.
I've been watching the house.
I'm gonna hang up and call the police.
Wait, no. Listen, Beth, I have not done anything wrong, okay? Look, I just want to help her.
Jason, hold on.
Beth, what is it? Beth, what is that? Beth, are you there? Shit. Fuck.
Excuse me, trespass much?
Hi, yeah, McKee. Just needed to interview you again. Producer said they needed a little more material on you. Is that okay?
Should I change or something?
No, you look great. The blue's great with your eyes.
Thanks. They're hazel.
Great. So you told me before that Carson got weird and so you stopped hanging out with her, right? But you said you were still friends?
Yeah.
Okay, so then why would she attack you at the intervention the way she did?
I don't know. I mean, she's crazy.
I mean, did you ever do anything to her that would...
No.
Look, McKee, I want you to be able to have a voice here, and I want to be able to hear your story.
I told you my story. I mean, I didn't do anything to her. I don't know why. Like, I think you should ask her that, because I'd like to know.
Well, your friends have already said a lot. I mean, you really don't want to look like a liar on national TV, okay?
Fine. We teased her. But that was it. I mean, we didn't think she'd take everything so seriously.
Teasing's not a big deal. What did you guys really say?
We told her that we believed in Satan. And, you know, if she was such a Christian, then why did she still want to hang out with us, you know?
Yeah, but she wanted to fit in. I get it.
I mean, it was mostly Kylie and Mark. I kind of wanted to see, I guess, how far she'd go with the whole thing. But, I mean, it wasn't real. Like, it was just a joke. She took it so far.
Okay, what exactly did you do, McKee? What did you do?
Nothing. We teased her. Like, that's it.
Okay, look at me. I'm not fucking around. What did you do?
We didn't do anything, okay? Whatever happened to her because whatever she brought in the room with her, okay? You can see from the video, it was all just a joke, okay?
Wait a minute. There's a video. There's a video.
Yes, there's a video. You're gonna make me look really bad on TV, aren't you?
Got her. This is gonna be so awesome. She's coming.
Yo, this is so much fun.
Yeah, this is good. You're gonna love this.
We do this all the time.
We've done it a bunch. Yeah.
It's a joke.
Hey. Codex Demonis. The Book of the Devil. It's the real thing.
Yeah, let's chant. Okay, everybody repeat after me, okay? Silence makes the demon come alive.
Silence makes the demon come alive.
Silence makes the demon come alive.
Satan hates us. Satan hates us. Satan hates us. Satan hates us. They drink the blood of the sacrifice.
Demon Moloch, we offer you this vessel.
Welcome him into you.
Guys, this
just keep going. Keep going.
Moloch. Come into me, Moloch. Moloch.
You just left her there.
Do you know what you did to her? Do you know what they're gonna do to her?
I didn't know, okay?
Okay, I need the book.
What book?
The goddamn book used in that ritual.
What
What are you gonna do with it?
Get me the book.
All right, I got the book. I downloaded some exorcism stuff from the internet. I'd like to have a priest there, but they put you on a fucking waiting list. And... oh, Jesus Christ, this demon is real and nobody's helping her. What?
Do you have one of our cameras?
Yeah, I'll bring it back later. I needed it.
Needed it for what?
To find out what happened.
Bring it back right now or I'll call the police.
Look, I'm going there to help her and then you'll get your camera back, okay?
You're not going back to that house, Jason. You're gonna bring that camera back.
What's the plan?
The plan is to get the footage and call the police.
What do you want?
Where's Carson?
I think I told you that we don't want to be part of your tele-
Where is she?
Hey! Where do you think you're going?
What the?
Look, we're not
What
doing
the hell
this,
are you doing
okay?
here? I told you that I want you people out!
Stop it! Stop it! Okay?
Where's Carson?
I'll show you! Just stop it!
Is that her?
Shit. Go, dude. Go up there.
Oh, my God. Just go. Follow me.
I'll stay down here and give Steve his Father of the Year award.
Got an OTI and some cutaways, too.
Okay, copy that.
Carson? The camera crew is back.
Hey, I got it. Carson, it's me. Okay, it's Jason. Can I come in? Fuck.
Here, put the camera down. Just see if you can see under the door.
Carson? Shit.
What?
What have you done? Okay, Ben, get some water and some towels. Get water and towels now. Steve.
Yes?
We're gonna do a quick little interview, okay?
Would you like a pretzel?
No.
No.
Thank you. Carson, can you hear me? Hey, Carson. Oh, what you do to your face? Fuck. Carson. Hey.
She's not!
Yeah. That's not true. Yes, she is.
Yes, she is.
And I know who you are. Your name is Malik, and you can be sent back from where you came. Okay. Here goes. Ever merciful and forgiving Lord, accept my prayer that I, your servant bound by sin, may be pardoned so that I can undertake this battle in your name. I cast you out, unclean spirit, along with every satanic power of the enemy. Be gone and stay far from this creature of God, for it is he who commands you, he who flung you headlong from the heights of heaven into the depths of hell. I cast you out from the servant of God.
Oh, my God.
Where's the breaker box?
Fucking lights. God! I'll show you.
Come on. Steve, the lights aren't.
Fuck it.
Fuck it. Where are you going? Where are you going?
I'll be right back.
Carson, it's me, Tim. Is that you? Carson, oh my God, come on, come in the house. Carson, what is that? Put that down! Carson, put that knife down!
Jason, take this.
All right.
I'm gonna go find Tim. Don't go anywhere.
Be careful. Tim! Tim!
Jason, we didn't tell you the truth. When you interviewed us, Carson is violent because she was raised in violence.
Beth, not now. We have to find Carson.
We've always had a violent home. And, Steve, he drinks. And when he drinks, he takes it out on me. And I take it out on Carson.
Oh God. Carson. Hey, I know you're in there.
you can hear me?
I know you can hear me. Don't give up. I'm here. I'm not leaving you, fighters. Come back to me, please.
No!
No!